Hello, hi, my name is Sylvia Jebet. I work in developer relations at Africa's Talking, and I will be doing a guide to basically show you how to get started with the Africa's Talking platform if you have never used it before. So as you can see on the Africa's Talking website, that is africastalking.com, and what we'll basically do is we will create a team and an app so that that is where you can access the APIs and monitor your apps. So to do that, we'll start by clicking on the developers section. This is where we land at the documentation side. And to get to our account, we will sign in. So if you do not have an account, you can register over here and create your new account. I have an account, so I will quickly log in. The registration process is very straightforward. Once you register, you'll get an email to verify your account, and that is basically it. You can now log in and access your account, as you can see from the screen. As your account loads, we were on the developer section. We can quickly tap on your icon on the top right. As you can see, that's where you see your account icon, and you click on the account. You land on this homepage. This is where we have teams. Now, teams are used to manage the applications that you create. For example, you can have several teams. We can just get started by creating a new team. This is where you'll be able to build your teams in and manage it. So we can give it a nice name, any name basically. So we'll say demo tutorial, and that's the name of our team. Once that is saved, it will be updated and you'll be able to see it over here. You can click on the team name to land on the team landing page. On your team, there are two sections, the app side and the member side. On the member side, you can add members to your team so that you can collaborate and work together. This is done as shown by adding the email, the access level that they have, and the data visibility for them. You can add as many members as you wish. But the app section is what we will mainly focus on, which will help you when you're creating your applications. So you can see I currently have no active apps, so let's change that by creating an app. We give our app any name, a cool name. So we'll do a cool demo app. That's what we'll call it. And now the username that you choose for your application has to be unique. If you do not input a unique username, you will get an error message. So ensure this is a unique username. I'll simply call it cool demo application. And then you select your country, wherever you are from. In this case, I will input Kenya as mine, where the currency code is in Kenya shillings, and you save it. That is basically how you create a new app. Whenever you want to do something, you will just create any app, ensuring that the username is unique. Once you're done, you can see it's added onto your apps list. And when you go home and you look at your team's demo tutorial team, you can see your app is right over here. When you click on the app name, as shown, you land on the app landing page. This is where you get all the important items or elements that you need in your code. One very important thing is the username, which is right over here. As I had mentioned earlier, it has to be unique, and this is why you use it in your code. You'll be calling it often in your code, so you ensure you know where it is. Another key element will be your API key, found here in the settings section. In the drop-down, there's API key. So what you basically do is input your password that you use to log into your account and generate. And once you generate, you get a value for an API key, which you can only see once. So when I click generate, this value is only seen once. It's already copied to your clipboard, but you need to save it because you'll not be able to see it any other time. The next time you come here, you'll be inputting your password to generate a new one. Those are the key elements for your account section. If you're a new member, your balance over here will be topped up with 10 shillings just to help you demo and learn how to navigate the platform. If you are a recurring member, you can top up here in the billing section using the payment methods, with whatever payment method that you use, and it will be very convenient. Another reason why the username was key, as you can see, if I select M-Pesa, it's a business number and my account number will actually be my username.api. Another reason why it needs to be very unique, because when you top up with this account number, automatically it reflects on your balance section over here, and you do not need to update your dashboard or anything of that sort. Other than that, depending on whichever product you're using, if it's SMS, there's a whole subset of menu items that you may need for SMS, for voice, the same for USSD and for airtime. And on your dashboard, you'll be able to see analytics and charts of your products and what you've used in your application. That is it for the basic guide of the Africa's Talking dashboard. With this, you'll be able to integrate it into your apps easily. All the best.